lateral ventricle. The lateral ventricles are the cavities of cerebral hemisphere. In each cerebral hemisphere, there is one lateral ventricle, and the lateral ventricle communicates to third ventricle through interventricular foramen of Monro. This is interventricular foramen. This part is interventricular foramen of Monro. This cavity is third ventricle, and this part is septum pellucidum. Very clearly visible in this. This part is septum pellucidum. This is septum pellucidum. This is corpus callosum. Corpus callosum. This part is corpus callosum. The largest commissure. The posterior expanded end is known as plenum. Then the body. Then the bent, the genu, and below and behind it is the rostrum. The two lateral ventricles are separated from each other by septum pellucidum. This is septum pellucidum. Now, let us try to see the structure around this, around the lateral ventricle. This part is corpus callosum. This triangular sheet is septum pellucidum. This part is body of fornix, dividing anteriorly as into anterior pillar, and this part is anterior commissure. Some of the fibers, they go in front of it to septal area. And majority of the fibers, they go behind it as post-commissural. The fibers going behind are known as post-commissural fibers. The fibers going in front are known as pre-commissural fibers. The pre-commissural fibers, they go to septal area, and the post-commissural fibers, they terminate in mammillary body. This part is mammillary body. And from mammillary body, two tracks starts, the mammillothalamic tract and mammillotegmental tract. The mammillothalamic tract goes to anterior nucleus of thalamus. This part is thalamus. The fibers will go to anterior nucleus of thalamus, mammillothalamic tract. And mammillotegmental tract, they go to reticular formation present in the tegmentum of midbrain. This part is the midbrain. This is midbrain. This is thalamus. Now, when we see the fornix, this starts from a mass of gray matter known as hippocampus. Hippocampus is present in the floor of inferior horn of lateral ventricle. This is the floor of inferior horn of lateral ventricle. In this, there is a mass of gray matter, this part. This is known as hippocampus. Hippocampus. At the anterior end, this part. This is a mass of gray matter known as hippocampus. Its anterior end having foot-like depressions known as pes hippocampus. This is covered by a layer of white matter known as alveus. And the fibers of alveus, they converge medially to form fimbria. This part is known as fimbria. This is fimbria. is fimbria. This part is fimbria. The fimbria becomes continuous with posterior pillar. This is fimbria. This becomes continuous with posterior pillar of fornix, and posterior pillar becomes continuous with the body. This part is the body of the fornix. Body of the fornix anteriorly at the level of interventricular foramen splits to form the anterior pillar, and the anterior pillar more clearly visible in this. This is the body. This is anterior pillar, and anterior pillar forms pre-commissural fibers and post-commissural fibers. Post-commissural fibers, they go towards the mammillary body, and pre-commissural fibers, this part is pre-commissural, it terminates in septal area. So this is all round. The fornix or hippocampus, this whole part is known as hippocampal formation, starting from the hippocampus. This starts from the hippocampus. Part is known as pes hippocampus, fimbria, then posterior pillar, then body of the fornix. This part is the body of the fornix, then anterior pillar dividing into pre-commissural and post-commissural fibers. This whole is known as hippocampal formation. This is present in the region of lateral ventricle. The caudate nucleus, this part is the head of the caudate nucleus. The head of the caudate nucleus. This part is the head, expanded part. This continues behind as body, and then inferiorly as tail of caudate nucleus terminates in amygdaloid body. Now, the choroid plexus of lateral ventricle also forms a C, part of it visible on the main portion of the lateral ventricle and part of it in the inferior horn. This is the typical C of this part. This part is the choroid plexus. This is choroid plexus. This is present on the upper part in between the thalamus and body of the fornix, and then it turns downwards to be present in the inferior horn of lateral ventricle. This part. This forms a typical C. Typical C. Typical is the cavity of the cerebral hemisphere. This has a main part, an anterior horn. The lateral ventricle has a main part, also known as the body of the lateral ventricle, and three horns. The anterior horn extends in the frontal lobe, the posterior horn extends in the occipital lobe, and inferior horn extends in the temporal. Now let us try to see the boundaries of the various parts of lateral ventricle. The anterior horn. Anterior horn is the part of the lateral ventricle anterior to the interventricular foramen. This is interventricular foramen. Interventricular foramen, which connects the lateral ventricle to third ventricle. The anterior horn has a roof formed by
the body of the corpus callosum. The floor of anterior horn is formed by the rostrum of the corpus callosum. This part is the rostrum, and laterally by the head of caudate nucleus. The medial wall is formed by septum pellucidum. This is septum pellucidum. And anteriorly it is bounded by genu of corpus callosum, this part. Now this is septum pellucidum. When we cut it, we can see the caudate nucleus. The structure visible. This is caudate nucleus. Complete caudate nucleus is visible. This part is the head of the caudate nucleus. Then comes the body, and then in the inferior horn we get the tail. It completely forms a C-shaped structure. The anterior horn anteriorly bounded by the genu of corpus callosum. Roof is formed by the body of the corpus callosum. Floor by the rostrum of corpus callosum medially, and head of caudate nucleus laterally. And the medial wall formed by the septum pellucidum, which separates it from the anterior horn of the opposite lateral ventricle. Now coming to the body, main part of lateral ventricle. This extends from interventricular foramen to splenium of corpus callosum. The main part of lateral ventricle. This is the main part extending from the interventricular foramen of Monro to the splenium of corpus callosum. This has the medial wall formed by the septum pellucidum. The septum pellucidum extends from the corpus callosum to the body of the fornix. The roof of the main part is formed by the body of corpus callosum. The floor contains a number of structures. This is fornix. This part is the thalamus. And more laterally, there is the body of caudate nucleus, this part. This is the floor. This is choroid plexus, the thalamus, superior surface of the body of the superior surface of the thalamus, the body of the caudate nucleus, and in between the caudate nucleus and thalamus there is a groove. This part is the groove, and in this groove two structures are visible. The bluish tinge visible in this, they are the parts of thalamostriate vein. This part, a band of white fiber. This band is known as stria terminalis. The stria terminalis, this part. Stria terminalis starts from the septal area and terminates in amygdaloid nucleus. The thalamostriate vein and the veins present in this, known as the choroid vein, they unite at the interventricular foramen in this region. The thalamostriate vein and choroid veins, they unite to form internal cerebral veins. The internal cerebral veins of the two sides, they unite to form the great cerebral vein and great cerebral vein, and the posterior end of inferior sagittal sinus, they unite to form straight sinus. Therefore, in the floor, the structures visible are the superior surface of the thalamus, the body of caudate nucleus, the groove present between these two structures having the stria terminalis, a bundle of white fibers, and the thalamostriate veins. Coming to the posterior horn. This is posterior horn extending into the occipital lobe of cerebrum. This has a roof, a lateral wall, and a medial wall. And inferiorly, this becomes continuous with inferior horn. The roof and lateral wall are formed by the fibers of tapetum. And on its medial wall, two elevations are visible. In the medial wall, two elevations are visible. This is lower one. This is caused by the calcarine sulcus. And the elevation is known as calcar avis. The upper one, this is formed by the fibers of forceps major. And this is known as bulb of posterior horn. The inferior horn of lateral ventricle, it lies in the temporal lobe. This part is the temporal lobe. This is the inferior horn showing its roof. This part is forming the roof, and this is the floor. In the roof, we see the structures which are present in the floor of the main part. They curve around it. This is choroid plexus, the sheath. This part, choroid plexus. Then, this is the tail of caudate nucleus. And tail of caudate nucleus, this goes anteriorly. Then there is a band of white fiber, the stria. This part, stria terminalis. This terminates in amygdaloid nucleus present in this region. In this way, in the roof, we will get the tail of the caudate nucleus, the stria terminalis. And the white matter of the temporal lobe. These structures, they form the roof, and this also includes the tapetum. The white matter of the temporal lobe, the tapetum, the tail of caudate nucleus, and the stria terminalis. These structures are present in the roof. This part is the floor. The floor shows two important structures. This is hippocampus covered by alveus, and then this becomes continuous as fimbria. And lateral to it, we get the elevation of collateral sulcus, this part. This elevation, known as collateral eminence. This is collateral eminence. The collateral eminence posteriorly expands to form a triangular area, the collateral trigone. The choroid plexus of the lateral ventricle is formed by two arteries. The posterior choroid artery, branch of posterior cerebral, they are present in its upper part. In the upper part, the posterior choroid artery branches of posterior cerebral. And in the lower part, we will get anterior choroid artery branch of internal carotid artery.